episode 1633, Are You Apologizing Too Much?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy every day. It is a brand new day. Rise and shine. Get your heart pumping. It is time to start asking some deeper questions. Are you apologizing too much? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you are going to have the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, it's going to be a busy week, isn't it? Yes, very busy and productive. Why? Because we have the 4th of July here in the United States. It's coming up on Thursday. So you are probably, if you're working out in the corporate world, things are going to be closing down. If you want to go to your banks or your post offices, you better start doing it now because people are going to take a really, really long weekend. So go ahead and start planning your family time now. But in order to do that, I think this episode is very poignant in where we are in our life, especially around the holidays. Are you apologizing too much? Saying sorry for being late, forgetting something, or just because of the weather? Maybe it's easier to let the sorry break the ice instead of expressing what really needs to be said. What is the meaning behind your apology when you say you're sorry? Is it just part of your vocabulary where you string words together for convenience but not truth? I was having dinner with my coach and mentor, Dan Miller, and his wife, Joanne. We've had Joanne here at Create Your Now on the podcast. If you haven't heard her episode, My Strength is My Story, go back and listen to it. I will include that in the show notes for you. It's Creating a Haven of Peace. It's an incredible book, and I know you will enjoy her interview. So go back and listen to that. And if you're not familiar with Dan Miller, he is a New York Times bestselling author of 48 Days to the Work You Love. He's an entrepreneur and an all-around courageous, inspirational, and authentic guy. I mean, he's like your dad. If my dad is no longer with me and I look at him and I just have such high respect for him and what he does and who he stands for. And it just is incredible. And I just feel so blessed. Him and he's worked with like Michael Hyatt and Dave Ramsey. I kind of like to look at them as kind of the trio of incredibility between the three of them, the trilogy, so to speak. It's amazing. Well, I was with them in our mastermind and we were having dinner together. Oh, and if you're wanting to connect with him, I will also put a link in there for the 48days.com community. He has an incredible Eagles community. So if you're an entrepreneur that wants to dive in, if you're interested in coaching, if you want support, this is an incredible community to become a part of. Okay, so now back to the story. We're having dinner together. It's our mastermind and we're having this conversation. We're kind of towards the end, of the table and Joanne's there and Dan's there and Dan makes a comment in regards to some of the things I was doing with him in regards to his community. And he says, I just love your enthusiasm. And my response was a quick thank you. But then I inserted an apology. I was like, and then I thought in my head, I was like, what? You just said you were sorry? I don't even know exactly how I said it, but I knew it was an apology of some form or fashion. Why was I apologizing? Enthusiasm is a good thing, right? Isn't it? And so then after I realized what I did, I went on to clarify why I responded with an apology. You see, when I go out to speak or people talk to me at random or they send me an email or we could just be in a conversation, people will say, oh my gosh, Christiane, you're so enthusiastic. Your energy is like you're on fire all the time. I love it. There's this joy that comes from you. It's not made up. It's just who you are. You're like a cheerleader. I can feel the inspiration. It runs through you. I just wish I could bottle you up so I could have all that energy. Okay, so I'm trying to backstep after I just said to Dan, I'm sorry that you just said that I'm enthusiastic and that's something that I am naturally. It's part of my personality. I came out born that way and it just has probably grown crazy like. I mean, you probably wouldn't be here listening to me now if there wasn't some enthusiasm in my voice. She'd be like, okay, if she's just going to talk like this about are you apologizing too much? That's really not enthusiastic. You're not going to want to stay tuned, right? There's nothing exciting happening here. Well, no, there is because you hear it within me. But even with that comment, I just love your enthusiasm. And it wasn't just a comment. It was a compliment. I was apologizing for it. Something that is all about me, who I am, what I stand for. Are you apologizing too much? Women have this knack for saying I'm sorry way, way, way too often. Men, yes, you say I'm sorry, but you don't do it like we women do it. It's crazy. Rachel Hollis writes about it too in her book, Girl, Stop Apologizing. There was a study that was done, and it was in England. It was a few years back. And they came to realize that people say, I'm sorry, 8 times. And 1 out of 8 people say it up to 20 times a day. Well, of course, when I had that little mishap with Dan, foot in my mouth, I was like, gosh, darn it. How can you take a compliment and turn it into this? I mean, it was a mess. He was giving it as a blessing and I turned it into this incredible mess. It was this pile of, oh my gosh. And as I continued to talk, I was like, Lord, get me out of this. I'm just digging a deeper hole. This isn't going to help me at all. And it wasn't like I needed any explanation. Dan is a man who doesn't need me to help him formulate his own thoughts. He can do it all by himself. Oh no, but I had to figure a way to make him understand why, number one, I said thank you, yet then I had an apology attached to why I'm so enthusiastic. And then I had to drag in this caboose of a reasoning that was built not just because of what I was saying, but because what others were saying. I was in a volcano of just, oh my gosh. It was a mess, beyond a mess. I was melting. And I just wanted to stop the conversation, rewind history, and start it again and just hear him say, I just love your enthusiasm. How cool would it have been for me just to say, thank you, period. Nothing else needed. Sometimes we apologize because we feel inadequate. Maybe we feel like we have to prove something. We feel like we don't measure up to the expectations of others. Maybe we feel shame about a situation or a circumstance, even if it's out of your control. You know, maybe you're apologizing because you just feel bad. Maybe you feel like you're just not good enough. Maybe you apologize because you always get something wrong. Maybe growing up, perfectionism was part of your lifestyle. You were a people pleaser or had to become that in order to survive. Us women, a lot of us are people pleasers. We need to be affirmed. And we don't like to talk about that because it makes us what? Uncomfortable. Because we feel like, okay, we have to be affirmed, yet we're talking about being affirmed, and then that makes me feel less than, and then, okay, do you see our problem here? It's a mess. And if you're one who feels like you always get something wrong, it's like you're apologizing up front before anything really happens. Maybe you just apologize because it's just in your vocabulary. Sorry just comes out. It's kind of like, hey, how are you? And it's, I'm busy. You run into somebody and it's, sorry. You text something 2 days later, sorry for the delayed response. Maybe you really aren't sorry. Maybe you truly were being productive. Maybe you were spending time with your family. So why do you say sorry? I'm sorry becomes this gate that opens up to your faults. It's the knee-jerk reaction for taking blame to escape the shame. Think about that. You say I'm sorry in order to take the blame to escape the shame. Exchange one for the other because you kind of feel like, what? It's already going to happen. So why not just go ahead and deal with it now? Let the consequences be what they are. Maybe you were hurt growing up. Maybe you had a bad experience in a job. A boss that just always tore you down, and no matter what you did, you just couldn't ever measure up, project after project after project. Maybe you married a spouse that honestly never saw the beauty of who you were and who you are today. Maybe it ended in divorce. Or maybe you reconciled, but there's still this underlying bitterness that I just don't measure up. I'm just not good enough. Maybe you put your dream on the back burner. Life got in the way. You didn't finish college, or you didn't go for that incredible career that you really wanted to. Children came along. Instead, you settled for something else because bills needed to be paid. You wanted to live a certain lifestyle. And you just feel like, I missed the mark. If you're apologizing too much, what can you do about it? Because it's not worth drowning in. Life is way too short. You don't want to take a compliment and turn it in to an incredible, destructive mess because all you did was, instead of just saying thank you, period, you continued on with something else that included an apology. So how can you escape this ongoing revolving door of apologizing? Well, you got to reframe your sorry. That is your KISS, the Keep It Simple strategy. Reframe your sorry. Instead of reacting all the time, respond. What would have happened if I would have just paused for just a moment and took in the moment, eating there, all of the hustle and bustle going around, hearing all the different conversations, yet when Dan spoke, I just love your enthusiasm, just looking into his eyes, watching his lips move, taking in that moment. And then saying, thank you so much for recognizing that. Period. That would have changed everything. I wouldn't have dug a ditch. I wouldn't have created this volcanic reaction that I did, where I just felt like I was digging myself out of, well, I don't know what, because I didn't get very far. And eventually, the conversation shifted. The waitress came, we had other things going on, and that little opportunity there faded away. Now, I haven't gone back to Dan and said, Dan, what did you take away from that, from my reaction to you? Because it was truly a reaction. It was knee-jerk. If you want to change the outcome when it comes to you're sorry, you have to think of the E plus R equals O, right? Event plus response equals outcome. You have to change that response. You can't react because reaction is what? It's knee jerk. That's what I did. And it got me into a bigger mess. And it didn't allow me to savor an incredible moment, for me to ask another question or two, to probe and say, what was it specifically that you liked about my enthusiasm? What drew you in? Who knows what I could have learned? Oh no, but that moment fizzled away. It was gone. Now, yes, I can talk to him and ask him again, but I can never recreate that moment. So if you're going to reframe your sorry, you got to stop reacting and start responding. So what does that look like? Number one, you have to have an awareness of how you apologize. Where are you using it? Listen to when you use "I'm sorry." Is it all the time? Do you get up in the morning and you brush up against your husband and you say, "Oh, I'm sorry." Why? Because you were just like a little extra close and you got a little, you know, discombobbled on your feet because you just got out of bed. You lost your balance. Maybe you could say, "Excuse me, pardon me." "Oh, hey, sweetheart." Why say "I'm sorry"? It's not your fault. No one got hurt. So think about what sorry means to you and understand the awareness. Be there, be present in which and how you apologize. Number two, you got to be attentive. Be attentive to the triggers and the situations or circumstances. What is it that gets your mouth to say, "I'm sorry"? Is there a pattern to how and when you apologize? It might be something that just always rolls off your tongue. You don't even think about it. It just comes out. I can think back, if I go to my texts and I look at them and I look at the last 10 people I have texted. Okay, usually your last 10, your previous 10, when you look at those are the ones that you most frequently are texting. You know, it may be your spouse, it could be your children, maybe your mom in there, your dad, a coworker, your best friend, etc. So you look at that. Scroll through just two scrolls up on your text. See if you find the word "I'm sorry." I know I have. And not just on one person's, on multiple. Be attentive to the triggers. How are you using it? Is there a pattern? It seems strange, but this has true ramifications when it comes to our daily life and with what? Our mindset. How we see ourselves, our self-worth. Where's our self-esteem? If you measured yourself on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being ultimately awesome and 1 being, "Oh, okay, I'm breathing." Where would your self-esteem be on a scale of 1 to 10? If you're using "I'm sorry" all the time, you're probably not very high on the scale. It's not going to equate. So you have to have awareness. You have to be attentive. And number three, you have to be assertive in the way you own your messes or your blesses. You got to own them. For me, when Dan gave me that compliment, "I love your enthusiasm," I should have said, "Thank you so much. That means a lot to me." And I could have gone on to say, so many people have told me how high my energy level is. In fact, they told me that if I could bottle that up, I would be a millionaire. Oh no, a billionaire. I don't know how many times I have been told that in my lifetime. A lot, where I wish I could bottle it up. But I don't get it. It's just who I am. I don't put it on that way. It's not fake. It's just me. It's all me. And sometimes I'm like, "Oh, I'm sorry." But I'm not sorry, because it's who I am. And for those people who are turned off by it, they won't show up. They won't either want to work with me. They may not want to be my friend. I shouldn't take offense to that. It is what it is. So when you are being assertive and you're owning your messes or your blesses, be specific about it. If it's a great thing, then why apologize? Say thank you so much. And if they feel a little awkward, let them feel awkward. You don't control them. You own those blesses. If it's a mess, if you run into someone and let's say their groceries spill all over the place, apologize. That would make sense to say, I'm sorry. And guess what? Help them pick up their messes. The mess that you created with the groceries all over the place. But maybe you're just in a crowded situation. You bump into someone, then say, excuse me or pardon me. You don't have to say, I'm sorry. Like, it's just me. No, it's you. An incredible human being created on purpose for a purpose. You are breathing air to impact, not just to, oh, excuse me, sorry. Do you see the difference? Awareness, attentive, assertive. Reframe your sorry. I wish I could go back into time, but I know I can't. But one thing I can do is I can learn. I don't want you to miss something so precious because you're in the habit of saying, I'm sorry. You're in the habit of apologizing. It's just too convenient for you to say. It's important for us to be present. It's important for us to recognize, to acknowledge, to be aware, attentive, and assertive, and owning who we are, the good, the bad, and the ugly. We need to own when we make a mistake, but we also need to own when we're a blessing. We need to own that with a smile. If you're one who says, you know what, I've been hanging around way too much with the I'm not good enough. Oh, I'm so sorry. I want to come beside you and champion you in your journey. I want to offer you a gift, a coaching call with me. Coaching can be very kind of nerve-wracking for some people because they don't know what it's like. They haven't experienced it. And so if you're one who says, gosh, I would really like to learn a little bit more about this coaching thing, click on the link, take aim in the show notes. And that will begin our conversation. We'll set up a time for you and I to speak. You don't want to go through life missing out because you're apologizing too much. And that's what happens. We don't want to own the goodness, the greatness that God brings into our life because we're always apologizing for it. Do you think Jesus went around apologizing for being the Son of God? He did wrestle with a few things, didn't he? But he wrestled with those in private, with counsel, with his disciples, people he could trust. You could consider that his mastermind. But he didn't go around apologizing for who he was. He didn't apologize for feeding 5,000s. He didn't apologize for changing water into wine. He didn't apologize for healing people. He didn't apologize for impacting. Think about what you're apologizing for. Is it truly an apology that's needed? Or do you need to reframe your sorry? You don't want to let the little stuff get in the way of the greatness to come. God created you on purpose for a purpose. One step at a time leads to your miles of greatness. It's not an apology here that he asks for. He asks you to be present, to be incredible, to be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.